If you were wondering what success looks like, this is what success looks like. AKA, rearing one of the biggest, most impressive and most beautiful species of tiger moth in the world and succeeding with them. So I'm very pleased because here I have my first cocoons of the Arias galactina. Arias galactina, as I said in my previous videos, but will repeat for new viewers, is one of the biggest tiger moth species there is in the entire world. I said one of the biggest, not the actual biggest, but it's still up there, and its colors are just incredible. So you have to stay tuned to see that, because I have not filmed the adults yet. And this seems to be their actually their maximum size. But as we can see, there are multiple cocoons in there. Here we have the first cocoon here, spun neatly in a leaf of bramble. But when we dig a little bit deeper, carefully to avoid the spines of bramble, here we see more cocoons being produced. And we also see some wet stuff here. And that's kind of dirty, but that's the gut content of pupating caterpillars who empty their gut before they spin a cocoon, because during the metamorphosis, it's not very productive to have a gut full of waste when you have to form a new body. So it all makes sense. And as you can see, I'm rearing them in plastic containers. Yeah, plastic containers with no ventilation, extremely high humidity. And guess what? They are not getting diseased or ill. They love it. This species actually needs an extreme high amount of humidity and does not require that much ventilation. I'm rearing them on a salad of multiple plants. Here we can see willow tree. They've eaten a lot of willow. Here we see bramble. But their absolute favorite is here on the bottom. It's laurel cherry, aka Prunus laurocerasus. And they've eaten a lot of it, it seems. I really mean a lot of it. So, as you can see, there's quite a few larvae left. Here we have a fresh cocoon being spun. I should not disturb this larva, actually. Maybe you can see it. It's a very fresh cocoon. We can still see the larva. And the leaves here are covered with larva. There are many left who still have to pupate. I'll be collecting some cocoons pretty soon, because it's nice to keep these cocoons apart, you know. Here we see an empty shed skin. So that means not all larvae are actually adults, some are still shedding. And here we see one that did not spin a cocoon, so I put it apart to pupate on soft tissue paper. And here we see a wonderful and healthy pupa of the Arias galactina. It's a nice wine red pupa, quite big for a tiger moth, really big. I've reared a lot of tiger moths in my life. And these are just one of the nicest that I've... What? Here we see something very strange. I just discovered a pre-pupa of Automerus between my... That's strange. Between my Arias galactina. I have no idea how that ended up in there, actually. It's a little bit weird. I think one of my Automerus escaped into this container and actually pupated. That's kinda strange, man. Here we have a cocoon. And I don't know why there's a larva on top of it, but I'll have to harvest some of these cocoons and keep them apart, so they can pupate in peace without being disturbed by their family and friends. If that's an appropriate term for an insect, of course not. There we go. Two cocoons, one pupa, many more cocoons coming up. So all in all, I have very good prospects with this species. So. One thing that's important to know is you should keep the cocoons very humid, because some of my friends have reared this species in captivity and ended up with dead pupa. It really sucks after all these months of rearing the caterpillar steel cocoon to end up with dead pupa, people. So don't fall into that trap. They need a lot of humidity and care, even as pupa. And they cannot stand the heat. Thanks for watching.